Hello and welcome to another video. Inspired by your friend's requests, I will talk about trees in this video, so we'll learn how to map trees in depth. And I'm in Rothaus Garden. Today, Rothaus Museum and Garden is where I work. And if you visit Rothaus in the summer of 2021, and if you use this code, you'll get 10% off your ticket. Isn't that great? And you might also get a chance to get a tour guided by me. Or one of my colleagues, but I would obviously recommend mine. So the garden is a reconstructed 17th century garden, and there is a first part that you see here. Behind me is the third house. There's a row of three houses. This is the third house built in 1610, and then there's a vegetable garden and a herb garden, and then behind the camera is a wall, and behind that is an orchard. So there are quite a few trees in the garden, and I think I've mapped them all already, so I have something to show you, and I'll explain the tags to use, and then I'll go and map another orchard with you, which is an estate in Kilkenny, which is also called Orchard, or the Orchard, and it has a couple of trees in it. So we'll do that. Let's go. And trees are really one of the easiest things to map. So you have your account, you log in, and then you can edit the map. Click on edit. And for trees, you just use the points. Unless you have a tree row, then you use line. But I'll just talk about points first. And now I'm in trouble because I've already added so many trees, so I have to look around for one that isn't mapped yet. Just in someone's back garden here in Blackmail Street. I'll just add the point. And then you can either type in tree in the search bar. It's already in my menu because I've mapped a couple of trees previously, and then you just click on that, or you go in, sorry, delete that, you have the point, and then you just type in natural tree, oops, tree, and that'll open a new menu here, and you can add the leaf type, the leaf cycle, the denotation. There's some interesting ones there, like urban or natural monument. So you don't use the name tag at all unless you know the tree personally, and I'm joking, if it has a name that isn't like lime tree, that's not a name, that's a genus. So if it is a natural monument or a landmark, like if it is a mile bush, for example. So find mile bush a mile away from the next big town. So there's one in Rossbirken. It's a mile away from New Ross, I think. And there are two outside of Kilkenny. It's a mile into Kilkenny. And they're called mile bush. And you can add those as a landmark, and then you can use the name mile bush because that's not the genus. But apart from that, you should never use the name tag for a tree. There's also park, so if you're going to map all the trees in a park, have fun, and you can use the denotation park for that. Or if they're along a street, you can use street. It's not an absolutely necessary thing to do. You can also use, for example, down here an orchard, which I could have done in Rothaus Garden. I didn't. But also religious, for example. If you have a rack tree near to a holy well, or next to a holy well, you can use that. But again, as I said, it's not entirely important. But it's something you can do, and you don't need to know the genus or the species to do that. But the friend who kind of requested the video was more interested in the genus, so that's what I'm going to concentrate on. You can also add the height and the diameter, which I'm not sure there's much point because trees tend to grow. But you can do that and then update your OpenStreetMap yearly or something. So we've added one there, and yeah, there's another big one here, for example, and they don't look like needle trees, so I'm just going to use broadleafed. I don't know what a leafless tree is. I'm not a biologist. Evergreen, deciduous, and all that. Look that up if you're interested in that. I'm not an expert. I won't tell you what to do because I will tell you the wrong thing. So I'll just save these added trees. Before you go on a survey using field papers, it's useful to have this done already. So if you want to do a survey of trees in your estate, look up your estate on OpenStreetMap, go in, edit. If it's an established estate where all the trees are already on the satellite view, you can use this method. If there aren't, because it's your new estate, or for some reason the trees have been only recently planted, you might have to use mapillary to locate them. I can't explain what mapillary is now. I have done videos on that previously. And sources Esri. And then once you've dotted your map with the trees using the ID editor, you can get your field papers and do a more thorough survey. And I will talk about that in a minute. I just want to show you that you see the trees there, but on the OpenStreetMap website, you can't click on any of them. And you can't, don't think you can search for oak tree or something like that. You can do that for these plaques, for example. If you know what there are, you could search for them and then click on them and get more information. It doesn't work like that on the OpenStreetMap website. It's a pity, but they can't do everything. But what you can do is you can run an overpass turbo query. I've mentioned them before as well, so I can't go into all that detail now. And you use the wizard and you type in genus equals asterisk, and that will give you the Latin name if people did it right. You use the genus and the species tag only for the Latin, is it called taxonomy? I'm not sure. Names for them. And I'll just click build query and I'll change this to node. I'll delete the other lines because the trees I'm looking for are only nodes. And then I'll just copy that line and paste it, and also add genus colon en, and that will also look for all the trees that have their English name, their English genus, added to the map, which I tend to do because I don't know all tree genus, I don't know, in Latin. I know some of them, but not all. And you can also use genus colon ga for the Irish name if you happen to know it. So now you see in this square, in this bounding box, most of them are, all of them are in Rose House Garden or adjoining, because that's where I mapped them. So if I click on one of them here, you saw these oak trees in the background of the introduction. They're Hullam oak, so if I click on it, it in alphabetical order shows you all the tags. Genus colon en equals oak, so that's the like family name, so to speak. And then species on, sorry, species colon en, species is like the full name, so oak is the family name, Hullam is the first name, so to speak. So Hullam oak is these seven trees in a row there. For some reason that one does have neither. I might have just put in species for that one. So this is what you can do. So the basic ones are natural tree and then genus colon en. That's a good start, I would say. If you want to get more specific, you can add the species, the Latin one, which is Quercus ilex. Quercus is oak in Latin. And ilex is something else in Latin, I don't know. And I also added the German name for this species. You can also add then the wikidata, but I'll go into that a bit later. But the wikidata is really useful for your survey, because you don't want to write Hullam oak. Well, unless you're an expert, you probably won't know. You might know that's an oak, but you wouldn't know a Hullam oak is an oak because the leaves look more like holly. I think that's actually a related word, Hullam and holly. That's what the leaves look like. It's an evergreen one, as I stated there. But if you use the Wikidata, it will give you all the names and all the languages if it's done up properly, but I presume it is for most of them. So that's the Hullam oak. Let's go on to these are apple trees, so we have a lot of apple trees in Roadhouse. These are genus :en is apple, and then the species here, I'm not quite sure if that's actually correct, it might be variety, is blood of the boyne. And we have other ones here, I think that one is a carry pippin. And then we have a mulberry tree here, so genus is en is mulberry, and there actually I added the Irish name and the German name, the German genus and the German, and the Irish genus, and there are, I think there are two species of mulberry, white and black, but this one is black. The Latin is, I think, Morus. And then there we have a fig tree here, so genus :en is fig. I think the Latin would be ficus. And then cherry trees, so these are the Morello cherries we have at the back of the garden. Genus :en is cherry. You'll probably recognize them by their leaves if you know a few things about trees. And then you'll have to wait for them to bear fruit and to taste them, I guess, to be able to tell it's a Morello cherry. And the Latin, I think, is prunus for the genus. There we have a quince tree. There's also a pear tree here somewhere. Yeah. So these are all the tags you can use to start off. And once you've added all the dots, you can go to field papers, print out your field paper. So I'm going to do that for this estate, as I said in the introduction, orchard. Sorry, move that a bit. So this is an estate in Kilkenny, and it's called the Orchard. It might have been a field name at some point, because this is New Orchard Road and New Orchard Farm is out there. So there must have been an old orchard somewhere, and this might have been it. So most of the estates around here are named after trees. Well, some of them. Beech Lawns, Rosewood, Orchard, Ashfield. Could have been a field name as well. So I'm going to print this out on one page of field papers and then go there and do the survey. And what I find useful with the Latin names, you can make a list and then use the first two letters. I'll put something on the screen now. And then use the first two letters to mark them on your field papers, because you don't want to write sycamore here and then sycamore there and then lime tree, because it's going to fill up your page pretty soon. But if you only use the first two letters and take your key, so AC for Acer, that's sycamore, QU for quercus, for oak, and you learn Latin on the way. Isn't that great? So that's one way of doing it. You can make up your own abbreviations, or you can make little symbols. And if you're not sure about identifying trees, either just leave them out, or I'm sure there are apps for that, which I haven't downloaded yet. I might do that and then correct what I've just said. But I'm pretty sure I can identify most urban trees. If you're going to a park, like originally I wanted to go to Woodstock Gardens, and it's, you know, one of those parks, a lot of the trees will be labeled, I would presume, and then you have it easy. Yes, let's move on. So here we are, the orchard, the estate that I'm gonna survey. And I printed out the field papers and also a list of all the trees I might be expecting. And I also got an app for identifying trees. It's called Leaf Snap. It works well so far. So this is all the trees surveyed using the app. I could have done with an extra hand. And you can also see that I added a few more trees that I had missed on the satellite view earlier. And I'll upload that now onto field papers and then start actually adding them to OpenStreetMap. So here we are on the fieldpapers.org website. I have uploaded it and it offers me to edit it in ID, Potlatch or JOSM, and of course I'll choose ID. and that opens openstreetmap.org in the editing mode. And you see that the background picture is now my piece of paper. So I can go in here and start at the beginning, and I won't show you all the trees, how I drew all the trees, but some of them. So the first tree, I think, where FG is for, get my paper, FG is for Fagus, which is a beech tree. So I can just mark, basically I can just mark all the same ones. That's very efficient. I'll just start with these. And then I can add genus Fagus and genus EN beech. And then I can add the Wikidata. I will have a list there for you. I might add a document to my website and give you a link in the video description, so you then don't have to find them out by yourself for everything. Q25, it's very small on my phone, 25403. And you see that opens this Wikidata thing here with the identifier. Have I forgotten something? I don't think so. Then we have Acer, so that's genus Acer. And I said that wrong earlier. It's not sycamore, it's maple. And the identifier on Wikidata is, oops, I should type Wikidata first. Q, let me see now. Is Q42292. And that's all you do, basically. And for some reason, after you've typed in the Wikidata number, it turns the colors a bit more into a gray shade rather than the black here. Did you see that? Well, I'll try that again for this one here. Another Acer or Acre. Genus Acer, genus EN maple, and Wikidata Q42292. Watch what happens. It turns it gray. Don't know why that is. That's all you do, and you just finish all your whole estate or your street or whatever you have surveyed. And for some of them, you see here, this was identified as Acer rubrum on the app. So I put that down, and I will not add that as a genus, but as a species. And the same down here, there was a Quercus robur. Don't know what that is in English now. I would know it in German. That's no use to you. But I looked it up again, and I also add that as a species rather than a genus. That's all you do. And I will save that then, and I will probably make a second video about how to make a map of all your trees then, where you can click on them and get the Wikidata and maybe add a picture or something like that. And that'll be in the next video. I hope you enjoyed that. I think it's a great idea for the summer holidays to get the kids out of the house and teach them a bit about trees, and maybe learn about the trees first yourself in your spare time, so you can impress them with your knowledge rather than using an app. But also, if you give them the phone you use the phone, let them find you find out what the tree is, and then you let them add your little abbreviation to the map or whatever. You know, it's your kids, you do whatever you want. Okay, so that's something to do maybe also during Heritage Week, because trees are also our heritage, aren't they? So that'll keep them busy for a while, and also in the shade, because trees are great for spending shade for you. So that's the video done. I hope you enjoyed it. Please like and subscribe, and also follow my Facebook page if you want to, OSM for History Buffs. And don't forget about the code to get a 10% discount in Rothaus for this summer. I'll put it up again here. Slán!